today forward, it is no longer legal to buy, sell, or transfer a handgun in Canada.
Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau made very clear that all handgun sales are now illegal in Canada. The regulation was announced in May but took effect today. The ban also keeps handguns from being imported. It's Canada's strongest gun control measure in 40 years and part of Trudeau's plan to tackle gun violence.
Bu yasa gençleri çok ilgilendiriyor arkadaşlar. Bazı gençleri çok ilgilendiriyor. Ben buradan 15 yaşında, 16-17 yaşında ve özellikle 2023'te Türkiye'nin kaderini belirleyecek 18-19-20 yaşında ilk defa oy kullanacak kardeşlerime seslenmek istiyorum. İstediğiniz yere tatile gidemiyorsunuz. İstediğiniz yemeği yiyemiyorsunuz. İstediğiniz tableti, kıyafeti alamıyorsunuz ve mutsuzsunuz. Bunun sebebi de bu AKP iktidarı ve maalesef peşine takılan MHP. Tek özgürlüğünüz var cebinizdeki telefonla. Instagram var, Facebook var, YouTube var. Orada haberleşiyorsunuz. Bugün 12 Ekim. Eğer buradaki yasa meclisten geçer ise arkadaşlar bu telefonlarınızı artık bu şekilde durup atabilirsiniz genç kardeşlerim. Kullanmanıza gerek kalmayacak. Ama 2023 Haziran'da o genç kardeşlerim size gereken dersi verecektir. Teşekkür ediyorum.
ردنا على الغرب نفس الكلام هذا نعيده بالإنجليزية. Anybody that challenges the existence of this country and this kingdom, all of us, we are projects of jihad and martyrdom. That's my message to anybody that thinks that he can threaten us.
Not pro-Russian. It's common sense. The working class of Europe have nothing to gain from this war and everything to lose. And I find it laughable that those calling for arms to Ukraine never called for arms for the people of Palestine or for the people of Yemen. Unlike you, I oppose all war. I want it stopped. I make no apology for that, and I'm not going to be scapegoated and labelled for it.
When the US killed over a million civilians in Iraq, was that terrorism? When Israel terrorizes the Palestinian people every day, is that terrorism? When France and the UK and others armed the Saudi UAE to commit genocide in Yemen, where the UN said that over 400,000 are dead and 16 million are starving because of a genocide being carried out with the support of the US, the UK, France and several European states, is that terrorism? When he's going to wake up and start living in the real world.
Local 4 News starts now with a breaking news alert.
Fireworks in Dearborn as a school board meeting is shut down early by the fire marshal. That decision was made due to the size of the crowd and what we're told was some rowdiness during a discussion on banning books.
Tim Pamplin is there on the scene with the night cam. Tim?
It was a scene of absolute pandemonium at the Dearborn School Board meeting this evening as hundreds of parents came out to protest a handful of books that are in the school libraries. Books that some parents say are pornographic.
It's called This Book is Gay by Juno Dawson. And it has some, like, chapter 9, the ins and outs of gay sex.
Decorum was lost inside the school board meeting as parents yelled and screamed, demanded to be heard. That's when the fire marshal stepped in, shut the meeting down, said too many people in this building.
Guys, they're going to shut down the meeting if you guys don't comply.
We're going to be recessing until we can get the situation under control. This is breaking the fire code.
I'm over here to celebrate victory because they walked down on us today, the school board, because we're not going to let them sit there and do their agenda, say.
And the majority of people that walked out of there truly felt that their voice wasn't properly heard because it got out of control. We need rational discussion in which people can come to grips with what the new moral standard is or what the new standard is.
These vocal parents and members of the community say they need to have their voices heard. They will not be silenced. The meeting was suspended tonight. It's going to pick up on Thursday at the much larger Fordson High School.
And we're going to go to Fordson, and we're not going to let them put the books on the shelf. I don't care what administration said, the books supposed to be on the shelf. These are books that should not be on the shelf.
Shame on you, bro.
So back out here as school board members leave the board offices here tonight. Parents out here tell me they will not be silenced on this matter. That is the scene tonight in Dearborn with the night cam. Tim Pamplin, Local 4.
حمد الرئيس أنا سعيد جدا بلقائك.
بالنسبة للبرزيدنت أول شيء أبغى
أسعدك. وأهنيك بعيد ميلاد سعيد إن شاء الله بالعز وطولة العمر.
شكرا.
عفوا يا سيدي.
No arms transfers in violation of Resolution 2231 have been ever conducted by Iran, and no drones were supplied by Iran to Russia for the use in the conflict in Ukraine. And I would recommend that you do not underestimate technological capabilities of the Russian drone industry. I can tell you we know what we do and we know how to do it. But I can tell you that first of all, the press secretary of the president said that they are Russian-made. Secondly, when you see the debris on the ground after they hit the targets, you would see inscriptions in Russian on the shell. So I don't think that Russian is very much widely used in Iran. I also heard that if you speak about Iranian drones, so they have the shape of some kind of American drones, they were copied from it. So can we say that Russian drones are resembling American drones or whatever? It's very difficult game of the words. But I would say that we have our drone industry, which produces the things that we need for this campaign. On the role of the UN Secretariat, it has no mandate to investigate anything regarding United Nations Security Council Resolution 2231. Its role, as enshrined in the note of the Security Council President 2016/44 of 16 January 2016, is purely technical, to prepare meeting rooms, circulate communications, etc. They are not a sanctions committee or its panel of experts. We have been dissatisfied with the overall performance of the Secretariat in the context of Resolution 2231. They act in a biased way, following the guidance from the Western capitals, and engage in illegal investigations in third countries, though they have neither mandate nor expertise to do so. After the Secretariat digs something, or rather studies whatever ready-made is handed to it by the West, they try to present it as the conclusions of the Secretary General. This is very unprofessional and casts a shadow on its authority. We hope that the Secretariat and the Secretary General himself will not again violate the decisions of the UN Security Council and will not go beyond their technical mandate and will abstain from engaging in any illegitimate investigation. Otherwise, we will have to reassess our collaboration with them, which is hardly in anyone's interests. We do not want to do it, but there will be no other choice.